Hi, my name is Josh Amsetz, and I'm the senior pastor at Lakeland. And on behalf of all of the pastors and the churches of Walworth County, I just want to welcome you to this very special live online event on behalf of or for the National Day of Prayer. Right now, what is really cool that's going to be taking place all over our county is people are gathering around online to pray together. One of the things that we recognize as pastors in this area is that we're all busy, and we struggle sometimes to gather together to connect. And yet, one of the things that is just so unique about our age right now, this time in which we live, is that we actually have the opportunity to be more connected than ever due to technology. And so we want to capitalize on that opportunity and use technology to come right into people's homes and to gather online to pray together. And so right now, all over Walworth County, individuals, families, small groups, and churches are gathering together to pray right now for our nation and for our communities on this National Day of Prayer. And so just thank you so much for joining us. Let me tell you what's going to be happening over the next 45 minutes together. We're going to be having right here a small kind of intimate casual service, and we're going to invite you to join us right where you're at. There will be moments as we're praying and as we're together that we're going to stop to take a break to pray, and while we're praying, we're going to encourage you right where you're at to stop and pray with whoever you are with. We're going to start right now actually with a very simple song of worship together. I want to invite you to join us, whether you want to sing along right where you're at or you just want to reflect on those words. Would you join us as we lift high the name of Jesus as we honor our Lord and seek Him tonight?
All sufficient sacrifice. is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus to break every chain, 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 break every chain.
My name is Jacqueline Hutchison. I'm a new member of Mount Zion Christian Church, and I've been through a lot myself and my four kids, and we had a tragedy last year that left us homeless for a couple months. And we asked God to keep us going. And he didn't give up. He provided. He provided more than what we asked. He's still working them. My kids have a good home. They have a good school, good education. It brought faith back into my home. My son is 15 years old, and he lost faith when we lost everything. And he got saved last week. So I just want to thank God for not giving up on us. No matter what we've done in our life, there's a lot to give thanks for. There's a lot to give thanks for. He's still working. He's still working on all of us.
Thanks, Jacqueline. Prayer really does work, doesn't it? I'm Pastor Dave Adams from Mount Zion Christian Church, and I'm going to talk to you about praying for our government. In 1 Timothy, it says, I urge you then, first of all, that petitions, prayers, intercession, and thanksgiving be made for all people, for kings and all those in authority, that we may live peaceful and quiet lives in all godliness and holiness. This is good and pleases God our Savior, who wants all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. The first thing I want to say as we begin to pray for our government, it is not a time to grumble. It says that we are to pray for our leaders. In our government, we have our executive branch, our president, vice president, all his advisors. We need to pray for them tonight and ask God to give them knowledge and wisdom. We need to pray for our Senate and our House of Representatives. And we need to pray for the Supreme Court and our judicial system. Every state, every town has a form of this government. And so tonight, I'm going to ask you to be in prayer for them and ask the Holy Spirit and God to go to Washington and to all the leaders in our nation. We are in a day where good is thought of as evil and evil is thought of as good. We want to pray that God will send his Holy Spirit to convict of sin, of righteousness, and of judgment. I would like to remind you that you should pray that God would put men in office that are not there to serve self, but are there to serve this nation. We're going to break now, and we're going to pray for our government. And I'm going to ask you to ask the Holy Spirit to go to our leaders, to turn our nation around, and bring us back to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let's pray.
Good evening. I'm Pastor Wes Lawson from the River Church in Delavan, Wisconsin. Yeah. How we see and understand our community, our state, our nation, our world is affected by what we see on TV, by what we see on the internet, and to some extent, what we see in the movies. It's also affected by what we hear on radio. It's affected by what we read in the newspaper, and it's affected by what we share on social networks. I'm here to ask for prayer for our media. I was trained in college to be a journalist. I was taught the power that the media has. The power to do good, to inspire, to expose corruption, and to see that change begins. And I've also seen that the power is there as well to desensitize us to things that are not of God and to destroy people as well. Media can be a powerful agent for good and for evil. As Christians, God calls us to use the media for good. In Philippians 4:8, we're challenged to focus on whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable. If anything is excellent or praiseworthy, think about such things. We should pray for our media, that all media personnel would report what is true, noble, right, pure, lovely, and admirable, as well as hard news that's done with truth and honor. We should pray for decision makers within the media to realize that they can make profit from doing family, friendly, values, wonderful projects. We should pray that Christians in media will find favor instead of ridicule and be filled with creative ideas that bring kingdom principles to the public. We should pray that celebrities will be provided with repeated opportunities to hear and receive not just the daily news, but the good news of Jesus Christ. Amen. So come on, people, let's pray now for our media.
Tom DeGroote. I'm the pastor at St. John's Lutheran Church in Elkhorn, Wisconsin. And I want to invite all of us at this time to consider the ways in which we can support our military in prayer. When I think about our military, any arm or branch, I think about what Jesus said. He said, there's no greater love than this, than one who would lay down his life for a friend. And we know that he calls us friends and he laid down his life for us, and that there are countless people throughout history and today who have laid down their lives, have given their lives, have shed their blood so that we could have the freedom this day to be sitting in our living rooms and in our churches and in our cubicles and on our cell phones and have the freedom in this country to pray, to speak openly to God and to invite others to do that. And these individuals, these men and women, stepped out to do that, much in the same way that Jesus stepped out to eternally save us and to give us freedom and eternal life. And so help us to remember that example. Help us to pray for them. I think back on my time in seminary. I had a good friend, an Assemblies of God pastor. His name was Ron. And he had a son who served in Afghanistan. And there were a couple of close calls while we were in classes together. And then about a couple of weeks before we had an intensive class, we got word that his son passed away. He was killed in combat. And it was only a couple of weeks later, we were out having some fried chicken at a chicken place. And he took out some cash to tip the waitress. And he showed us the dollar. And he showed us where it says, "In God we trust." And he said, "You know, before my son died, we used to sit around and we'd talk politics. And we'd complain about politicians and policy and all of these things. But last couple weeks, every time I look at a dollar, I think my son died for that. My son died so that I would have the freedom to eat this chicken, so that I would have the freedom to sit around and have an opinion about the president and about policies and all of these sorts of things. And so for the rest of my life, I'm not going to do that anymore. I'm just going to thank God for that freedom." And so my prayer for us and for you, that we would come together, that we would thank God for the freedom that he has given us as Americans, that we can come together, that we can pray, that we would use that freedom, that we would pray, that we would actually pray, and specifically that we would pray for those who have afforded us this freedom, that we might pray words such as the prayer that the mighty warrior David prayed in Psalm 144, that we would pray these things over our military men and women, that they would be blessed by the Lord, that the Lord would be their rock, who would train their hands for war, their fingers for battle, that he would be their steadfast love and their fortress, that he would be their strong, steadfast stronghold, that he would be their deliverer, that he would be their shield, and that he would be the one in whom they take refuge, that he would be the one who would subdue people under their hands. As we go into prayer, let us pray for these men and women.
Hello, my name is Pastor Todd Harger. I'm from Faith Baptist Church in Delvin. I want to share a couple scripture references for you, and we're going to talk about the church today. Looking at John chapter 4, it says this, when Jesus was speaking to the woman at the well, he says this, in starting at verse 25. But the hour is coming, and is now here, when the true worshipers will worship the Father in spirit and truth. For the Father is seeking such people to worship him. God is spirit, and those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. And then Psalm 133 says this: "Behold, how good and pleasant it is when brothers dwell in unity. It is like the precious oil on the head, running down on the beard and the head of Aaron, and the beard of Aaron, running down on the collar of his robes. It is like the dew of Hermon, which falls on the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord has commanded the blessing, life forevermore. There's something very unique happening here in Walworth County, where the Refreshed Church is uniting around what they can agree on. And they are then therefore uniting in spirit and truth to proclaim the good news. We're not focused on what is dividing us. We're focused on what is uniting us. And what is uniting us is the good news that Jesus Christ has died for our sins and provides a way back to the Father and a restored relationship with Him. This nation needs and is in need of churches that will unite around that message of hope and good news that salvation comes from the Lord, that life forevermore is found when churches come together in unity and proclaim in spirit and truth the gospel of Jesus Christ. Tonight and today, we want to call all churches to unite. May the Refresh movement break forth from Walworth County and go throughout the nation. And we want to ask now that we would unite in prayer, that churches would get back on mission, proclaiming the gospel, worshiping God in spirit and truth, and then again unite and carry that message to the ends of the earth. Let's join in prayer for our churches.
My name is Father Joel Prather. I am the pastor of Christ Episcopal Church in Delavan. And I want to lead us in a time of prayer for our local businesses. One of the things that I'm really convicted of is that local businesses can stand in and help with the work of redemption. And one of the reasons that I feel that way is because of the story of Boaz in the book of Ruth. This is a man that built wealth, managed it well, used it wisely, and used that wealth to bless others, to become a goel, a kinsman redeemer to Ruth. And that's the line that our Lord Jesus Christ came through. And I think that there's a connection there worth paying attention to. And as I look at our communities and the businesses there, I see men and women that run excellent local businesses and do it in such a way to be kind of a kinsman redeemer that for those that are vulnerable, like a Ruth in our community. And so I think praying for our local businesses is much more important than maybe we even know sometimes. And so I just want to lead us in a time of prayer and get us launched into that. So if you'll please join me.
name is Dave Hawley, and I'm the pastor of Christian Life Church in Delavan, Wisconsin, located between Elkhorn and Delavan on Highway 11. I am here today to share with you about education. I was a high school principal in Williams Bay, Wisconsin for a number of years, and I can assure you that there is a great need for continuous prayer in the field of education. The goals and content and approach of education has changed dramatically. From the schooling that children received when our nation began, our newly formed government took on responsibility of helping to educate their children. In 1635, the Boston Latin School became the first public school in America. With the teaching of the Bible as part of the foundation of classroom teaching, many of the teachers were pastors, and there was a reverence for the Almighty God and His precepts as part of true knowledge. Isn't it wonderful that Christianity was a part of the educational system, even in the public schools? Quite a contrast from today. Much has changed in our educational system. In many subject areas, concepts such as pluralism and tolerance have been introduced, and at the same time, a rejection of absolute truth. Textbooks in colonial days promoted a faith-based worldview, while today's curriculum often include and even condone immoral activities and lifestyles. Much of the revision of educational materials in reference to the Christian principles and the Christian foundation of our nation have been removed. With this type of atmosphere pervading our classrooms, it is especially critical that we pray for this nation's public school teachers, administrators, and students. And we thank the Lord, the present dedicated educators in public, private, and home schools who are honest, good role models, and teach the subject matter accurately. Let us remember to uphold our local school boards in prayer as they make decisions about the various curricula that are used across the county and the country. Let us close with this scripture in Hebrews 13:6 in the Amplified Version. So we take comfort and are encouraged and confidently and boldly say, "The Lord is my helper, and I will not be seized with alarm. I will not fear or dread or be terrified. What can man do to me?"
We're going to pray now for families. And some guys have said, well, Josh, obviously you should do families because you've got the largest. You've got 9 kids. And so you talk about families. And well, that's true. That I do have probably one of the largest families in Walworth County. I am not necessarily the master on families, but I can tell you one thing that I've known to be true as I've been a part of a family. I grew up as the youngest child with two older siblings. I can tell you this, I blew it as a sibling. I blew it as a child to my parents. I've blown it as a parent for my children. And I've blown it as a husband for my wife. Now you can sit there and say, me too. And think to yourself, all right, so we've all blown it at times. Now what? Or, oh well. But for me, I look at it and I look at Scripture and I go, no, God has called the family to something absolutely beautiful and wonderful. And while we've probably all blown it at some point, God has a beautiful plan for the family. And so I pray that we would discover the strength and the grace and the perseverance to become the great siblings that God had in mind. That I would be the great child that I can be to my parents. That I can be a great parent for my children. And that I can be a great spouse to my wife. Only by the grace of God and by the strength that He allows. And so I ask that you would join me in prayer right now for our families, the families of our nation, but the families also of our county, that we would pray that unity and love would permeate the families, that we would pray that there would be a reestablishment of broken relationships between parents and children, that we would pray for the return of biblical values to the family unit, that we would pray for wisdom for parents to be bold, to raise their children in the way that they should go, that when they are old, they will not depart from His word, that we would pray for husbands to be servant leaders and for marriages to look at one another as their spouses, best interests above their own, that we would pray for blended families, for single parents, for foster parents, adoptive parents, that God's grace and wisdom would pour out over all families. So would you join me right now in praying for families? Thanks so much for joining us tonight on this online service of prayer together. I just want to leave you with one verse. This is 2 Chronicles chapter 7, verse 14. And this is what it says. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will hear from heaven and will forgive their sin and will heal their land. And as I read that, I think to myself, it's great that we've gathered together to pray. Isn't it awesome that our entire nation today has rallied around prayer and has sought the Lord? And isn't that great? But I just wonder, what would happen if we prayed tomorrow also? What would happen if the people of Walworth County didn't just rally for one day, but what if we prayed tomorrow? And what if we prayed the day after that? And what if we prayed the day after that? What if we didn't just pray for the sake of gathering and saying, rah, 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 we trust in you, God, for one day? But what if we became a people who desperately needed the Lord and prayed? And we became a people totally just desperate for the Lord, and we were a people of prayer.
Well, then I would say probably like this verse says, what if we became a people who would seek his face, that we would humble ourselves, seek his face, that he would hear us from heaven and that he would actually heal our land, that he would heal the children in our county, that he would heal the families in our county, that he would heal the marriages in our county, that he would heal the addictions in our county, that he would heal the educational system in our county, that he would heal the businesses in our county, that he would heal the governments, governmental leaders in our county, that he would heal the villages in our county, that he would heal the cities in our county, that he would heal our county. If not just gathering for a day, but that we would actually become a people of prayer. If my people who are called by my name will humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I'll hear from heaven, I'll forgive their sins, and I'll heal their land. Amen?
Amen.
Amen.
Thanks for joining us during this National Day of Prayer special online service for Walworth County. For more information of how to get involved in praying, go to National Day of Prayer website at nationaldayofprayer.org/get involved. Thanks again for joining us.